Hi everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you how to add a simple border and drop shadow to an image with Photoshop, and how to customize the effect by choosing border and shadow colors directly from the image. I'm using Photoshop 2021, but any recent version will work. If you like these videos, be sure to subscribe, and let's get started. Start by opening your image. I'll use this image from Adobe Stock. In the Layers panel, the image appears on the background layer, and at the moment, the background layer is locked. To place a border around the image, we'll need to add a new layer below it, but we can't do that while the background layer is locked. So to unlock it, click the lock icon. Or if you're using an older Photoshop version and clicking the lock icon doesn't work, press and hold the Alt key on a Windows PC or the Option key on a Mac and double-click. Photoshop renames the layer from Background to Layer 0, and the lock icon disappears. To create the border, we'll use a solid color fill layer. Click the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon at the bottom and choose Solid Color from the list. Then in the Color Picker, choose White by setting the R, G, and B values to 255. We'll use white as the border color for now, but I'll show you how to change it later. Click OK to close the color picker. And the white from the fill layer blocks the image from view. To fix that, click on the fill layer in the Layers panel and drag it below the image layer. Release your mouse button, and now we're back to seeing the image, with the fill layer hiding behind it. Next, we need to add more space around the image, and the extra space will become the border. Since we'll want the size of the border to be the same on all four sides, the best way to do it is with Photoshop's Canvas Size command. Go up to the Image menu in the menu bar and choose Canvas Size. Then in the Canvas Size dialog box, make sure the Relative option is checked. This tells Photoshop to start with the current canvas size, and the values we enter for the width and height will be added to it. In the anchor grid, make sure the center box is selected so the extra space will be added evenly on the top, bottom, left, and right. Then enter a size for the border into the width and height fields. Start by choosing your measurement type. I'll use inches. Now keep in mind that the values you enter will be divided equally between two sides. So for example, entering 2 inches for the width will result in a 1-inch border on the left and right of the image. And entering 2 inches for the height will give you a 1-inch border on the top and bottom. For my image, a 1-inch border will be a bit too wide. A 3/4-inch border will look better. So to add a 3/4-inch border on the left and right, I need to set the width to twice that amount, which is 1.5 inches. And to keep the border the same size all around, I'll set the height to 1.5 inches as well. Then click OK to close the Canvas Size dialog box. Photoshop adds the extra space around the image, creating the border. If you can't see it, go up to the View menu and choose Fit on Screen. The space is actually transparent, but it appears white because the solid color fill layer below the image is showing through. The only downside to Photoshop's Canvas Size command is that there's no way to preview the new size before accepting it. So if the border is too wide or too narrow, you'll need to undo it by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Undo Canvas Size. Then go back to the Image menu, back to the Canvas Size command, and try again with different width and height values. So we have the border around the image. Now let's add a drop shadow behind it. In the Layers panel, click on the image layer to select it. Then click the Effects icon and choose Drop Shadow. The options for the drop shadow open in the Layer Style dialog box, and the three main options are Angle, Distance, and Size. Angle controls the direction of the light source. Distance is how far the shadow extends away from the object, and Size controls the softness of the shadow edges. I'll move the dialog box out of the way so we can see what's happening. The fastest way to set the shadow's angle and distance is to simply click inside the document, keep your mouse button held down, and drag the shadow to position it. As you drag, the angle and distance values in the dialog box will change. or you can enter specific values. I'll set the angle to 135 degrees and the distance to 80 pixels. The value you need will depend on the size of your image. Then increase the size value to soften the shadow edges. The higher the value, the softer they appear. I'll set mine to 60 pixels, but again, it will depend on your image. You can also adjust the intensity of the shadow using the opacity slider. Higher values darken the shadow, and lower values lighten it. I'll lower mine to 30%. Then click OK to close the Layer Style dialog box. So at this point, the main effect is done. But instead of using white for the border and black for the shadow, we can customize the effect by choosing colors directly from the image. To change the border color, double-click on the Fill Layers color swatch in the Layers panel. But instead of choosing a new color from the color picker, move your mouse cursor over the image and click on a color to sample it. And that color becomes the new color of the border. You can try out different colors by clicking on different parts of the image. And when you find the one you like, click OK to close the color picker. Then to change the shadow color, double-click on the words Drop Shadow below the image layer. And in the Layer Style dialog box, click the shadow's color swatch. Then just like we did with the border, click on a color in the image to sample it. Now shadow colors need to be dark and highly saturated. So in the color picker, increase the saturation, the S value, to 100% or close to it. And then darken the color by lowering the brightness or B value. I'll set mine to 30% to keep the shadow from looking too dark, but you may want a lower value. Click OK to close the color picker, and then click OK to close the Layer Style dialog box. And there we have it. That's how easy it is to add a border and a drop shadow to an image with Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you found it helpful, don't forget to like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Visit my website, photoshopessentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.